Let's find a gentle class. So kind of like Monday nights at 6 kind of thing. We'll do a little bit of joint freeing. We'll wiggle ourselves around. We'll find a little bit of movement in bodies that might not be moving as much as they usually do. Remembering that we are all being patient with ourselves. So we do the stuff that feels really good. You might do it over and over again. If we start to do something that doesn't feel so good, maybe shy away. Maybe find another way to put your body into that shape. Remembering that it's so much better and so much easier to adapt the shape to fit these bodies than it is to jam our bodies into shapes that don't work. So being patient and gentle and kind. Gathering up a couple of blocks and a strap and a blanket, perhaps. If you don't have these handy dandy things at home, think about pillows and books and ties or belts, anything that you can use to support yourself. I think we're ready to go. Come on down onto your mat in your very favorite shape to start practice. Think about lying all the way down on your mat. Think about being able to either stretch those legs all the way out, or maybe if low backs are a little bit tender, maybe we keep knees bent, feet planted. You could even plant feet nice and wide so your pinky toes can feel the edge of your mat, and then let your toes could be kind of pigeon-toed, let your knees drop together. Again, think about where your shoulders want to relax down. Maybe it's nice and wide. Maybe you've been working over something, or have you found yourself curled forward? And so the antidote is to find arms wide, palms open to the sky. Maybe we are feeling a little bit introverted today. Maybe we want to bring hands over hearts or bellies. Maybe we want to tuck arms in along our sides. Finding whatever feels natural. Whatever feels like it's where you need to be, and that's where we're going to land. We are going to find ourselves with a smooth, even breath. Thinking about an inhalation that lands just below our belly button, an exhalation about the same length. Encourage that breath to be a little bit deeper and slower and rounder. Think about hands on chest and on belly. Follow the progression of that breath all the way down and back out again. Maybe acknowledging that it is our breath that needs this practice as much as our achy knees and sore shoulders. Natural and easy, not so much attention being paid, not so much concentration. Breath smooth and even. Let's take time to check in with this body that carried us through the door. Check in right from the top of our head down through the soles of our feet, and just notice. Notice the spaces where we are feeling anything or everything. Check in with spaces that need our care and compassion today. Spaces that might be a little bit tight or tender. Remembering prepared to check in without judgment, without getting caught in the story of why things feel the way they feel. Just notice what is. Think about what is landing on your mat with you today. Checking in with heart space, with head space. Remembering that everything affects the way that we move, the way we breathe, the way we connect with our practice, with ourselves, with each other. So monkey mind and emotions have just as much effect on our practice as achy low backs, bum knees, tight shoulders. Once we have noticed what is landing on our mats with us, let's take a moment or two to find an intention for this practice. Look for your words, look for a phrase that encourages you, that challenges you, that inspires you to move. Making sure that our words are kind, making sure that they are set in the present. Tucking them away in mind's eye, imagine being able to draw them on the inside of your forehead. A place to take your attention when things move too fast. A place to remind yourself what landed you here. Tucking that intention away in mind's eye and letting yourself drop into five of the biggest, slowest, roundest breaths that you can take. Inhale in through your nose, fill up your belly, move that breath into your rib cage, let it expand, move that breath all the way into the top of your chest, think about collarbones rising. Exhale, like pouring water out of a glass, release that breath from the top of your chest, through your rib cage, down into your belly, and then look for four more, just like that, the slowest, most intentional breaths that you can take. And if it seems like a challenge to find a long, smooth breath, think about three sips of air, a sip of air that lands in your belly, a sip of air that lands in your ribcage, a sip of air that lands in the top of your chest. That long, smooth exhalation is often a little more accessible than that big, full, round inhalation. Find what works. Long, exaggerated, slow, controlled breaths. And at the end of that fifth, really slow, complete exhalation, let's drop back into that full, even rhythm, the rhythm of breath that's going to fuel our practice. And let's start to wiggle our fingers and toes. Let's take time to roll out wrists and ankles to shift some of our snaps and crackles and pops. Start to stretch ourselves out. We can stretch out wide, heels wide, arms wide, or stretch out tall. Toes pointing away, fingers reaching toward the wall behind you. Let go of groans, yawns, great big sighs. reaching hands toward the wall behind us if they aren't already, drawing our feet together as tall and long as we can be. Let's shift both heels over the bottom right corner of our mat. Perhaps even cross that left ankle over our right. We're going to shimmy shoulders just a little bit to the right as well. Take right fingers around left wrist. Reach up and away on the left side. Start to reach to the right just a little. Think about a long, smooth smile from the outside edge of that left foot out through those left fingertips. As much space in our left side body as we can find. Shimmy ourselves back to center. Take both ankles over to the bottom left corner of our mat, perhaps cross right ankle over left. Shimmy shoulders just a little bit to the left, switching sides, left fingers around right wrist, reaching up and away on the right side, reaching to the left. Long, smooth line from the outside edge of that right foot out through those right fingertips. Maybe we take a couple of really consciously full, exaggerated breaths. Feel that stretch through our rib cage. Start to wiggle ourselves back to center. Slide our arms open wide. Start to bring one foot to the floor and then the other. Maybe we pick up our hips, settle them back down. Maybe we just feel that grounding through the back of our hips. Think about being able to anchor yourself through hips and shoulders, the back of our head, the soles of our feet. Taking our feet about, step apart. Just let your knees start to drop from side to side, progressively getting a little bit closer to the floor. Not worrying about connecting with our breath just yet, letting ourselves wiggle, move around. Start to connect with the little messages the body start to send us when we start to move around. What we're really doing is rocking from one edge of our feet to the other. As we get to that place where our knees are getting a little bit closer to the floor and head and neck and shoulders are feeling pretty good, let's start to send our chin in the opposite direction of our knees. Remembering that we're not concerned about how close our knees get to the floor, we are just looking to move. Maybe this is where we start to connect our movement with our breath. Maybe we let out that exhalation or a sigh, let knees drop in one direction, chin in the other. Let our inhalation draw nose and knees back to center. Exhale and drop into the opposite side. Maybe knees move together as a unit. We start to find a little bit of freedom in that movement. Maybe the top knee comes back to center, starts to move to the opposite side before the bottom knee finds its way off the floor. Maybe we let ourselves hang out in the twist for an extra breath or two. Remembering that this is your very own practice above all else. So you find a groove that fits today. You hang out with stuff that feels like it's making space. Letting ourselves
Find one more twist to the right. Drawing back to center. Dropping that twist to the left. All the way back to center. I'm going to keep that left foot planted on the floor. We're going to draw our right knee in toward our chest. Let your hands land wherever they need to be to keep that right knee tucked in. Think about keeping that knee tucked into the midline, so a little bit closer to center than dropping off to the side. Think about drawing your chin in just a little. Smooth, even breaths. We're going to ease off the hold on that knee just enough to let that left leg stretch all the way out. Remembering if it's not a good fit, we just bring that left foot back to the floor. Shift around so that right hand at the top of our right knee. Stretch that left leg out if it isn't already. And start to draw some circles on the ceiling with that right knee. Let your hand move your knee around in space. Left hand can open at shoulder height or tuck in along our side. Maybe these circles start out really tiny and get a little bit bigger and rounder. Maybe they stay tiny and small. If there's a space around that circle, it feels really good to hang out in. Take an extra couple of breaths in. Follow your intuition. Next time your knee lands back at your belly, send a few of those circles in the opposite direction. Starting out tiny, getting a little bit bigger, a little bit rounder, hanging out in the spaces that need attention. Next time your knee lands back at your belly, we're going to switch hands. We're going to take that left hand to the outside of our right knee, right arm down, or open. And imagine that we can draw that right knee over toward our left shoulder. So a really subtle movement. Think about that right hip staying pretty close to the floor. Think about actively drawing that right knee toward our left shoulder. Side, right hand in front of our shin, hug it in nice and tight, and see if we let that right knee drop now toward our right armpit, coming off the side of our chest a little bit. We're drawing back to center, switching hands again. Left hand to the outside of our right knee. Let's take that right arm open at shoulder height and start to draw that right knee as far to the left as it would like to go. And if we get to the point where that right shoulder is starting to pull up off of the floor, start to reach that right hand toward the wall behind you. Remember, we are not concerned about how close that right knee is to the floor. We're thinking about being able to wring ourselves out. We're going to drop that right hip Drop that right foot down to the floor. Left foot is going to come back to meet right. Again, take time to wiggle yourself back to center. Feet in line with hips, in line with shoulders. Maybe we pick up our hips, settle them back on the floor. Checking with the places that we are grounded. Soles of our feet, hips, shoulders, back of our head. This time, keeping that right foot planted, drawing our left knee in toward our belly, keeping it close to the midline, finding the place that we can hug that knee in as tightly as we can. Maybe we tuck our chin in a little. Maybe we check in with that breath. Maybe we shift back into that smooth, even breath. Easing the hold on that knee and seeing if we can stretch that right leg all the way out. Again, remembering if it's not a good fit, we just bring our foot back to the floor. Letting that right leg just be heavy. It's just an anchor. See if we can breathe a little bit of space into the front of that right hip. Stretching that right leg out if it isn't already, right hand to left knee. And this time we are drawing our left knee toward our right shoulder. Left arm is open at shoulder height. Again, that really subtle movement. It's not a great big twist. Just looking for a little bit of space between the outside edge of our left hip and the outside edge of our left knee. Drop back to the left side, left hand comes back to the top of our knee. So we can let that left knee drop off the side of our chest, thinking about left knee toward left armpit. All the way back to center. We're taking that right hand back to the outside of our right knee. Left arm opens at shoulder height, and we're going to start to draw that left knee as far to the right as it would like to go. Checking in with that left shoulder. We can stay open at shoulder height or reach that left hand toward the wall behind you. Not worried about how close our knee is to the floor. We might drop our chin toward our left hand. Again, thinking about that sensation of wringing ourselves out. All the way back to center. Drop that left hip. Left foot comes down. Right foot comes back to meet it. Let's bring one knee in toward our belly and then the other. Rock a little bit from side to side. Hands to the tops of our knees. A couple of those big round circles. Knees dropping in opposite directions, meeting at the midline, drawing back to bellies. A few of those circles in the opposite direction. All the way back to center, hands in front of our shins, tuck in tight. One foot down to the floor and then the other, rolling onto our sides, hands tucked under heads. Find a couple of breaths.
Top hand comes down. We peel ourselves up off of the floor.
And find whatever easy seat it looks like in your body. So this might be where we grab onto blocks or blankets or pillows. Maybe something to lift our hips up a little bit. Okay, so I have to admit, as we all adjust ourselves, the time goes way too fast. And just like in real class, I forget stuff because totally forgot hip circles on the left side. So whatever easy seated looks like in your body, think about crisscross applesauce, think about legs extended out, maybe one of each. Think about shoulders back and down. Actually, think about shoulders back and down all the time. Back and down, back and down, back and down. It's the antidote to your shoulders trying to kiss your ears. Land your hands on your knees or interlaced in your lap or pressed into your thighs if you're getting that sensation that you're just a little too wiggly. Maybe hands into our hip crease. And let that left ear drop toward our left shoulder. A couple of really slow nods, chin to chest, ear to shoulder. Sky. Drop your chin down toward your chest. Imagine that your head is so heavy that you can't possibly hold it up. Crown of our head back toward the sky. Let that right ear drop toward our right shoulder. Slow nods. Crown of our head back toward the sky. Let's take that right hand down beside our right hip. Start to lean into it a little bit. Start to walk it away, lean into it, let your elbow kind of bend down toward the floor and reach that left arm up toward the sky. And if you have room, start to reach that left hand over to the right. Think about being able to keep shoulders stacked one over top of the other, not leaning too far forward or too far back. All the way back to center, shifting to the opposite side. Hands wiggle away, elbows bent just a little. Start to reach up. If there's room, reach to the left. All the way back to center. Shoulders back and down. Left hand over to our right knee or right thigh. Right arm reaches up toward the sky. Exhale, drop that right hand in behind our right hip. Gaze about halfway up the wall. Smooth, round breaths when we're inside that twist. Draw yourself all the way back to center. Right hand over to that left knee or left thigh. Left arm up toward the sky. Exhale, drop it in behind our left hip. Shoulders wide. Let your left shoulder help draw you into that twist. Gaze about halfway up the wall. Smooth, even breaths. Shift ourselves onto hands and knees, taking time to set yourself up with extra padding if it makes life easier. We're going to land with wrists under shoulders, knees under hips.
Gaze just beyond your fingertips, thinking about as long a line from the crown of your head down to your tailbone as you can find. Maybe we even have room to flatten the fronts of our ankles toward the floor. Just start to move. Inhale to lift nose, curl hips toward the sky. Let your belly soften toward the floor. Tucking our tailbone, let that wave move up the length of our spine. Reach our nose toward our belly button. Again, let hips curl, belly softens, nose lifts. Back and forth just a couple of times. Time you find yourself in that round back cat pose. Let your hips sink back toward your heels. Find a child's pose with lots of space. Lifting all the way back up, round back. Let hips curl, belly soften, nose lift. Walking hands forward, reaching as far forward as we can. Let the top of our chest melt toward the floor. Lifting back up, all the way back to neutral. Hips back toward heels, this time taking knees wide. Lifting back up onto elbows and knees, finding a few rounds of cat and cow just from a different perspective. Shifting onto one hip or the other, gathering up all of your comfy cozies. Time for final relaxation. I'm going to grab onto a blanket. I'm going to let myself lower all the way down. I'm going to keep my knees bent. Let myself be a little bit pigeon-toed. Let myself relax down onto the floor. Maybe we stretch all the way out. Maybe we stretch ourselves out like starfish, heels wide, arms wide. Maybe life is more comfortable if we curl up on our sides. Maybe that's where final relaxation is in your body. Maybe it's in child's pose, or maybe you wiggle over to a chair or the couch or a wall and find legs up the wall or knees on a chair. Finding the space that fits best to catch our breath, to let the benefits of our practice sink into skin, bones, hearts. So wherever you are, let your eyes close. Find your breath. Whatever natural, easy rhythm happens without too much thinking. Yourself be still and quiet. hands for a few moments more. Staying quiet and still. So these words are from our friends at Briony. Every spring, just before the cherry blossoms bust a move in Hyde Park, portions of the park are roped off for what they call a controlled burn. Pockets of the woods are burnt to a crisp so that plant life can be regenerated. Green shoots will soon sprout out of the ground, new beginnings in all their glory, which is almost hard to believe in the mix of soot and ash, will find their way through what remains. I've been thinking about this and how it relates to us and our beingness. How every now and again we burn everything we've built down to sometimes bones so that we can create new ways of believing. The process of dismantling things as we know them are often painful and uncomfortable. But the thing is, we are every part nature. We know, even when we think we don't, even when we are holding on for dear life, wrangling with our preconceived notions of what we don't think we know. We know that resistance is futile. The burn will happen. We will fall completely apart. We will survive. New, great, and wondrous arrivals will spirit from our destruction. This is what I'm remembering through my controlled burn. I am not alone. I am held and supported. I am loved unconditionally. I am not my rock bottom. I am just beginning to sense my new life sprouting. And maybe you are too. So wherever you are, still, relaxed, and full and easy, hands to heart center, taking a moment just to be grateful. Namaste.